It was that strange start to the 90s.
And all the great themes have been used up, turned into theme parks. So I don't really find it exactly cheerful to be living in a totally, like, exhausted decade where there's nothing to look forward to and no one to look up to.
I wore all black, too much black eyeliner and black Doc Martens because it made me look hardcore and rebellious. I just started playing AD&D with my friends, got my first set of shiny red dice, and read the Dragonlance Chronicles obsessively. Considering D&D was considered to be the work of Satan in those days, I thought it made me more hardcore, but actually probably just cemented my nerd status. But throughout all of this, there was the music, and a big part of that soundtrack was Meatloaf. I sat around feeling smug because I had figured out what he wouldn't do for love, but other people just didn't seem to get it. I came for the scary looking album covers, but stayed for the rock and roll. 30 years later, I've managed to pass down my love of both D&D and Meatloaf's music to my teenage daughter. His legacy continues, except now I listen to the music while cleaning the house, instead of hiding in my bedroom avoiding my parents. He will always be remembered, because deep down, my 16-year-old self will always be listening. And we know that objects in the rearview mirror may appear closer than they are.
And objects in the rearview mirror may appear closer than they are.